And our first main topic today gets submitted to us by Christian Rubiano. Christian Rubiano. And Christian Rubiano writes, "Hope you enjoyed Turkey Day. I did. Thank you very much. What is it?" Oh, by the way, and I should let you guys know that this question was submitted by Christian on our Open Mic podcast, which is on our podcast only feed that comes into us from our Patreon supporters. But I thought this one was really interesting, so I thought we'd cover it here today on the show. What is it about Zack Snyder's directing style that elicits such a strong response, either positively or negatively, from audiences? I know all films are subjective, but not all directors garner such passionate responses every single time out. All right. Thanks a lot for sending that in, man. And yeah, listen, it is a really good question. You know, the name Zack Snyder, although it has never been before, but in recent years, Zack Snyder's name has kind of become a lightning rod, if you will, of discussion and sometimes controversy. And he has become that something that I would argue, through no fault of his own, kind of the poster child for what a polarizing director or a divisive director really is. And again, I think it's through no fault of his own. So it's understandable that Christian would ask, you know, what is it about his directing style and what it is he does that makes him so polarizing, so divisive, that elicits such positive responses and such negative responses at the same time? I would argue this. He really doesn't. I would argue that despite all the hoopla we've had the last number of years, Zack Snyder inherently himself is actually really not all that polarizing, nor is he really all that divisive. I think he just, through no choice of his own, kind of got prompted and pushed into this position of being the poster child of the ultimate Marvel fanboy versus DC fanboy war, if you will. And I think Zack Snyder inadvertently and involuntarily kind of became the face of that. Think about this for a little while. When you look at Zack Snyder's work, much like we break our calendar into BC and AD, let's look at DC and ADC. Let's look at Zack Snyder's career before DC and since he started doing DC movies. Well, you look at films like 300, which people, you know, loved. Legends of the, I think, is most underrated. Other than Man of Steel, of course, which is the most underrated comic book film of all time. But one of his really more underrated films, Legends of the Guardians, the Al Ghul, this little animated film he did that I actually really quite like, and nobody ever talks about it, but I think it's quite a good movie. Then he did The Watchmen. Not everybody loved The Watchmen, but, you know, considering the fact that it was considered for a long time, Rob, to be an unfilmable comic book story, like absolutely unshootable. The fact that half the people love it is kind of a testimony, but it never really, even though people are kind of divided over Watchmen, it never really made people divide over Zack Snyder, you know? Then you get Sucker Punch, the one Zack Snyder film I don't like. The only one that he's ever made that I don't like is Sucker Punch. But again, nobody, it never made every director has a bad day at the office. Even Steven Spielberg has a bad day at the office. I think Sucker Punch was Zack Snyder's bad day at the office. Then Dawn of the Dead, which a lot of people, I know you, Rob, in particular, have a real affinity for Dawn of the Dead. The point is, before he started doing DC movies, he's made some really strong movies. He's made a couple that maybe weren't all that strong. Every director does. But Zack Snyder's name, Rob, prior to him doing Man of Steel, prior to him coming into the DC universe, was never a polarizing name, was never a divisive name, was never a lightning rod name, even though he was making his films. He never was that. It wasn't until we get to the point that he's doing the DC movies. Man of Steel, which I believe is a masterpiece of the genre that he did, but whenever I bring that up, my comments and whatever get filled with people saying, "You don't know what you're talking about, can't be a Man of Steel sucks." And that's fine. That's fair. All films subjective. I got no problem with that. But I think it's bloody brilliant. And then, of course, Batman versus Superman, Dawn of Justice, which a lot of fans hated, a lot of fans loved, blah, blah, blah. And then Justice League with whatever, you know, the hoopla and the circus that surrounded that. My contention is that it's by coming into DC and really launching the DC universe when Marvel was coming up and coming around so strongly. Again, I believe he became the poster child for really that war. that war between DC and Marvel, even when DC and Marvel and all their executives were publicly encouraging each other and showing support for each other and blah, blah, blah. Meanwhile, the Marvel DC slave fanboys and the Marvel DC slave fanboys and the DC, you know, comic book slave corporate fanboys, they absolutely went to war. And gratefully, Rob, today it's not quite as bad as it was just a couple of years ago, but the vitriol that was always involved in anything that would involve the Marvel or DC discussion, because as a corporate zombie fanboy, the Marvel corporate zombie fanboy was programmed and predetermined that if anything came out DC, regardless of how good it might be, was automatically going to hate it and bash on it and villainize it. Meanwhile, the corporate zombie slave DC fanboys were automatically pre-programmed and pre-decided that anything that came out DC was the best thing in the world ever, and that anything Marvel absolutely sucked. And Zack Snyder launching this thing and then kind of becoming the face of it with Batman versus Superman. And then, Rob, you had a lot of people that were more in the middle, like you and I. Like, I didn't love Man of Steel because it was DC. I personally love Man of Steel because I just thought it was a great movie. And I know there are some people who hated Man of Steel, not because they hate DC, but just because they didn't like it as a movie. But you got those extremes, those Marvel corporate zombie fanboys at the time years ago and the DC corporate zombie slaves on the DC side. And I think really when you look at it, yeah, there are movies that people liked and people didn't like, and that's fine. But I think it was him, Zack Snyder, getting caught in the middle of this comic book movie fan civil war that really made him kind of the face of it, and therefore the image, the physical representation of what it meant to be a corporate Marvel zombie slave or corporate DC zombie slave, and he became that battle point. And I think, again, that's why I say, yeah, I agree, Zack Snyder is kind of a polarizing and divisive director, but I contend it was neither voluntary on his part, nor is it even his fault. He just got dragged into a battle that the companies never wanted to have, but the lesser mature sides of the fandom decided to have. And I think that's it. And you know what, Rob? I think, too, you could also say, and tell me what you think about this, but I think Zack Snyder's name is only as polarizing, as divisive amongst those people who still kind of hold on to that Marvel versus DC fanboyism. I think if you talk to a lot of average film fans, they hear the name Zack Snyder as a director and they may recognize it, they may not, but I don't think it elicits any strong feelings one way or the other. I think it's still kind of remnantized to those two more extreme points of view, and it kind of becomes a symbol of that war and that battle. That's my take on it at any rate. Rob, when you hear somebody writing in a question and asking, you know, why is the name Zack Snyder so polarizing, blah, 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 why do you think that's a state, and where, and is it really as bad as that as they're making it out? What do you think?
Well, I think you made a really good point about the comic book nature of the battles that go on between fans, movie fans, and comic book movie fans. But people have to remember that, you know, he made 300. That was his first comic adaptation, and that was a beautiful, I don't think anyone who liked Frank Miller's comic didn't like Zack Snyder's movie, because it's such a loving, he took what was on the page and beautifully recreated it and gave us a great adaptation of Frank Miller's 300.
I don't know anybody that doesn't like it, to be honest with you.
And I think that's where, so Zack Snyder, remember, that was a comic book adaptation, not a superhero adaptation, but comics that people liked. And then I think what happened, like for me, I was really, Watchmen was a really mixed bag for me, because I love the slavish recreation to the comics that he provided from a visual standpoint. I just didn't feel the intellectual rigor was there that made the comic book so, why I'm such a passionate fan of the comic book. And like with Man of Steel, I saw things in Man of Steel, such as the fight with Zod and Superman, like the scene where they're punching each other in the air, flying with super speed.
Yeah,
I had never seen anything like that before. And that is what it would look like if two Kryptonians were fighting above an American city. It would be an apocalyptic event that made 9/11 look like, you know, a walk in the park. And you never want that to happen. And he showed that. And for whether you're a detractor or not, Zack Snyder's superhero work has had a quality to it unlike any other director's. The problem, I think, is that he's not bringing to the characters of, say, well, mostly Superman, the kind of qualities that most people expect, people that are fans. He's trying, it's a much more dark and it's a much more realistic take on what Superman would be like in our world today. Also, with Batman v Superman, it's obviously a film that's overstuffed. Although I think that he brings a quality to these movies that no other director brings. And I think it's a combination of painterly, and I think it's just different. And, you know, where the MCU is more traditional comic book panels and things like that, Zack Snyder went the sort of Alex Ross painterly way of doing things. And he's not providing – his superhero movies don't put a smile on your face. They make you kind of go, rrr. Whereas if you watch Civil War, you get a big smile on your face watching that airport battle. It's brightly lit. You know, even though the friends are fighting, their friends are foes, but it's just different. It's you're watching it in broad daylight. There's no lightning cracks in the sky, and there seems to be less CG, even though there isn't, but it's set more in the real world. And I just think the tone of Snyder's movies is different than what people want. So he's become a divisive character in that way. But like you pointed out, it really became when Marvel was doing what they were doing so successfully, he was doing something tonally that was so different from what Marvel was doing that people weren't, you don't feel great about yourself when you walk out of a Zack Snyder superhero movie. You walk out of Captain America, the First Avenger, or you walk out of Iron Man, and you're like, yeah, man, that was awesome. But you walk out of a Superman and Batman movie and you're like, oh man, that was kind of rough. That was kind of heavy. So it's a whole different feel. And I think people are responding to that. But I understand that what people want is they want the same feelings, maybe not the same content, but they want to feel the same way about their superhero characters. And I think Zack Snyder doesn't do that, you know, but he's never done that. 300, Watchmen, Sucker Punch, Dawn of the Dead. Certainly Dawn of the Dead ends, every character dies, you know, and it's not, he does not leave you with a wonderful taste in your mouth. He leaves you with more of a contemplative, dark taste in your mouth. And I think that's what people are responding to. But what's interesting is, why not spend some time reflecting on that rather than, like, I look at Zack Snyder's movies, I'm like, that's interesting. He's giving me something new to think about as opposed to reinforcing things that I've already thought. And that's why I enjoy his movies. Look, I was so against, you know, Dawn of the Dead is the original Romero Dawn of the Dead, is one of my favorite movies in the world. I was so against. I walked into that movie, John, I'm like, I'm going to hate this garbage. Even though James Gunn wrote it, screw this guy for remaking one of it. You know what? After the first 10 minutes, I'm like, okay, I'm in. And for him to bring me around like that on that movie, I will always give him at least a pass and contemplate what he's doing before I pillory him on the internet.
Here's the interesting thing. Like, that you bring up something really interesting that I think kind of became a spark point for a lot of the debate, was the darkness of his films. And I remember thinking, you know, The Dark Knight, The Dark Knight Rises. These were darker tone films. Like, I always contended that I don't think, you know, where there are weaknesses in Zack Snyder's DC films, I don't think that the dark tone is necessarily one of them, because we saw that in Dark Knight and Christopher Nolan's films, but nobody really seemed to claim. What do you think about that?
Well, you know, I think when I say dark, you know, Christopher Nolan is setting his movies in the real world. Like, he shoots outside in Chicago. He'll flip an 18-wheeler on an actual street. Whereas, like, and during the day, whenever you get outside during the day, the sky looks real. In Zack Snyder's movies, even the sky looks like it's painted. It almost it looks, his whole milieu feels, I mean, people forget Michael Keaton's, Tim Burton's Batman movies were very highly stylized. And while they were also over the top, they were also really dark in terms of the way they looked. I think it's really more of an aesthetic thing. And also, you know, his Superman character, when the portrayal of Superman, it isn't all, Superman's not smiling like, hey, Lois, you know, let's go see what's out there in Metropolis. And it's not, you're not getting, it's so far away from the portrayal of Superman as we've seen him, as Christopher Lee played him, as Dean Cain played him, as he's been played on the CW shows, because the counterpoint is the CW shows really feel like, the DC shows, I mean, on the CW, they feel, the Arrowverse, they feel so light and lively, you know, as opposed to the weight of the world that Zack Snyder's movies bring. And I think people are more responding to that than anything else.
Well, guys, the question is for you. What do you think about that when you hear people asking, because like, why does Zack Snyder suddenly become this lightning rod thing when he really wasn't before? I've presented my theories, Rob's presented his. What do you guys think about that? Jump down into the comment section below and let us know your thoughts. All right, guys.